Hi, my name is Jim Devlin, and I'm going to walk you through this game called On the Road to Jericho. The basis of the game is it's the traveling tales of the nation of Israel as they left Egypt in slavery behind and walked through the desert, through the wildlands to the promised land. It took them 40 years, as the Bible story tells us, and we'll face six different challenges on the road to Jericho and the Promised Land. So let's go ahead and get started. We'll click here to start. And this is just a short introduction. Understanding that not all learners are going to be familiar with the way the system is set up, we'll also give directional arrows pointing to where we need to move going forward or backwards. And when we do our challenges, we'll see a check mark there as well. So we'll move on to the next. Little further explanation, the challenges do not have to be completed successfully, but there's no rewards if you don't complete them successfully. So to start, we'll go ahead and choose one of our tribe leaders, if you will, following on the 12 tribes of Israel. These are four of the sons of Jacob, who became known as Israel in the Bible. And these were his four most famous sons. Reuben was his firstborn. Judah was his fourth son. And this is from descendants of Judah is where the kings of Israel came from. Joseph was his favorite son. And Benjamin was the youngest of the sons. He was son number 12. Throughout the course, we'll also find Did You Know features that you can click on just for a little bit more information. So we'll go ahead and choose Benjamin. Our first challenge is water. 3 days after the Israelites left Egypt, they were running out of water and were very thirsty and began complaining. So that brings us to our first question. How long can you last without water? Well, a normal human being, can only last 3 days without water. Had I chosen the wrong answer, I would not have gotten as affirming of a message. This question is responding to the last bit of information that God always provides for the Israelites. So I can type anything I want in here. This is an open field. And then I can submit it. And it will tell me my score of how many stones I've gathered. So the goal of the game, as we read in the very first screen, is that we need to win 12 stones so that we'll be able to build an altar at the end of the game. So we're on our way. We have our first two. Our second challenge is food. First, there was water and the dilemma there. Shortly after that, the Israelites were starting to get hungry, so they began grumbling to Moses again. And this question is a little tough wording. We want the people to thinking about it. If they're thinking about themselves as one of the tribe members, they have no food and they need to find some fast. What would you do if you were with the Israelites? Well, in the Bible, the Israelites did not ask God for help. They did not hunt for food. There was no grocery store to go to, so they did complain to Moses. If I were to choose the wrong answer, unfortunately there were no stores back then, so I missed my opportunity to get a stone. And this is just an explanation of manna, which is what God provided, a wafer-like bread or cracker that would cover the ground each morning. And then at night, there would be quail to feed on as well. And we want the students thinking about how all this relates to their own faith life. So we're talking about our daily bread, which was what manna was as declared by God. And which of these prayers, three common prayers, do we talk about that? If I need to study my prayers, I can go ahead and click through. That's not it. That's not it. Ta-da! Give us this day our daily bread. So I will choose the Our Father. Check to make sure I'm correct. Yes! Another open-ended question. If I need a hint, I can always click here to get my tip. So they should rest on the Sabbath. And go ahead and check my scores. Yay! Two more stones. Our third challenge, are the Ten Commandments, and this is just an introduction to the commandments story. I'll put my first three commandments in order. These first three are those commandments which relate to our relationship with God. First one, I shall have no God. I am the Lord your God. You shall have no strange gods. We should not take the Lord's name in vain, and we should remember to keep holy the Lord's Day. Now, this is where we start looking at the multiple intelligences upon which this game and our course has been created. We want the students to be able to have the opportunity to write their own commandments here. So, from the list of the seven commandments below, we need to choose three to rewrite them for our lives. Say, number seven, don't steal online subscriptions. So if my three friends and I all share the same Netflix subscription, that by law is stealing, so I am violating commandment number seven. A little bit of a typo there. We actually did get some stones on that one. Moving through to the fourth challenge, now we're talking about the covenants. Just a short story to try and develop the narrative. As any of us have sat around campfires listening to our elders tell stories, this would be a common thing. And the first four covenants, which are all that we've covered at this time, we need to put in order. So Adam is the first, followed by Noah. Moses is the last at this point. And in this activity, we have to match the covenants with what God said in the Bible. So we'll do the easy ones first. For my part, here's my covenant. I will make you the father of the multitude of nations, is what he told Abraham. We keep gathering those stones. Challenge 5, Moses. Moses is one of the key features of the Old Testament, and we actually break his life down into three different stages. The early days, which would be the days in Egypt. The exile and the return, when he was chased out of Egypt, or rather running for his life out of Egypt, after he killed a man, and then his return 40 years later. And then the time in the desert, as he was leading the nation to the Promised Land. And we can click here, get a graphic image, and then a short story, just a couple sentences talking about those times in summation. Now, if we read the stories before, on the slide before, we knew that Moses' life was set up into three stages of 40 years each, so our answer is 120 years. In this sorting activity, we'll look at each of these 12 options and drag them down. The burning bush, that happened in exile, found in a river as a baby, happened in Egypt, told God he was not worthy when God was calling him to go back to Egypt, the 10 plagues against Egypt, still in the exile stage because it was while he was returning to free the people. He was raised to be a prince originally in Egypt. So Moses violated an order that God had given him, and he was not permitted to enter the promised land. Manna and quail, as we saw earlier. The golden statue is something we didn't talk about here, but they've covered earlier in the class. Ten Commandments. And his wife Zipporah, who was covered in the class, the other previous lesson as well. Had I chosen any of these and dragged them onto the wrong block, they would have turned red, and I could just click on them again and choose the correct field for them. And again, I apologize, those stones are not counting properly. Our sixth and final challenge at the end of our journey. Again, a short description to tell the story. Just to give some background information. And now we'll look at matching these five different activities with these five different locations. On the shores of Jericho, this is where we built our altar, or we will build our altar. The path from the desert is where Moses was buried. Middle of the river. And this was just gleaned from information that we saw on the previous two slides. Now we should have enough stones by now, so let's see our final results slide if we have enough stones to build our altar. And that is our game. Thank you for your patience, and I look forward to hearing your review.